Good morning. Today let's build a VS Code extension. We will write an extension that will work kind of like the Quokka.js. It will output the runtime values of your variables right in the editor. Our version will be a bit more simple, and if we run it on this file, it will output the values for each of the variable in global scope. So let's run wombat. And here you go. X has the value 10. And as you can see, this text here is an overlay. So it's not a part of the file, it's just a decoration. First, we need to install Yeoman. It's a scaffolding tool and a special plugin to generate VS Code extensions. npm ig yo and generator code. After it's done, run the generator yo code dot. Let's create new extension using JavaScript. Let's call it wombat. I will change the identifier because I already have the wombat extension on my machine. Wombat vid, and I'm gonna skip all the other steps. Now let's go to the project directory, cd wombat vid, and open the code editor. Open package.json, and in the contributes block, change the command title to wombat, or any other title you want. Now open extension.js, and we need to do a bunch of imports. Const path equals require path, const util equals require util, and we need to import inspector. Inspector require inspector. Inspector is a built-in node debugging interface. It allows you to get the runtime values, just what we need. Now let's make the activate function asynchronous. Async function activate. And first thing we do here, we activate the inspector. Inspector open. We open a session. We can remove this log and the comments. Now we need to create a new inspector session. Const session equals new inspector session. And then we call session connect. Now we can talk with the inspector session using the post method that allows us to post messages to it. By default, the post interface is callback based, and callback based interfaces are not very handy, not very convenient to work with. So let's transform it into a promise version. Const post equals util promisify session post bind session. Now we need to enable the debugger. So we post a message post debugger enable. As it is asynchronous, we need to await for it. And also we'll need to get the runtime information. So we post another message runtime enable. Inside of the command callback, first of all, let's make it asynchronous, async, remove the comments. And first thing we want to do here is to get the active editor. Const active editor equals VS Code window active text editor. We need to check if we have the active editor. If not, active editor, return. And having the active editor, we can get the currently opened file and its contents. So we can get the reference to the document. Const document equals active editor document. And also we can get its file name. Const file name equals path base name document URI to string. Now we need to compile the script in this document, and we will need the script ID. Const script ID equals await post runtime compile script. We need to pass the options object. The expression will be document get text. So we compile the script from the contents of the currently opened file. Source URL is file name and persist script is true. After we've compiled the script, we need to run it. We will do it by referencing it by the script ID that we got after compiling it. Await post runtime run script and options object, and we pass script ID. Now we need to get the list of all the variables in the scope of this script. So let's create const data equals await post runtime global lexical scope names. And we need to pass the context ID, which in our case will be 1. Execution context ID 1. Now we need to get the value for each of the variables in the global scope. So we loop through the names in the data constant using the map function. We pass there an asynchronous function that will get an expression, and the expression will be a variable name. So we'll run runtime evaluate to get the result value. And it equals await post runtime evaluate. Then we pass an expression that is basically a variable name that we are trying to get the value from, and context ID equals 1. Now we need to know where those variables are located in the file to properly display the values in the editor. We'll create a new constant, we'll call it result by calling await post debugger search in context, and we pass the options. We need to pass the script ID and the query, which in our case will be the expression, which, as I said before, is just holding a variable name. Now we need to add that overlay that shows the values in VS Code. It's done using the decorators API. Let's create a helper function, add decorators with text. Scroll up and define a new function. Const add decoration with text equals a function that accepts the content text, line on which it needs to render it, column, and the link to the active editor. Inside of this function, we create a new decoration type. Const decoration type equals VS Code window create editor text editor decoration type, and we pass the options there. After content text margin 20 pixels. So we create a new text editor decoration type that will render the text 20 pixels to the right of the decorated section. Now create a new range, new VS Code range. We're defining a range here because VS Code decorations can be not only the text, but you can, for example, underline some portion of the text or highlight it using colored blocks or some other visual representation. We pass new VS Code position, line, column for the beginning and for the end, because we don't really need the whole range. We need one point where we want to render our values. And then in our active editor, we set decorations, pass the decoration type that we've created, and then we pass the range. Scroll down, and after we got the result from searching the text in the context, run add decoration with text, pass the value there, wrap it into a template string. Then we need to pass the line number, result 0 line number, and column number, which is result 0 line content length, because we want to render the value in the end of the string. And then we pass the active editor. Let's change the information message to done. And now we can launch our extension. You can do it by either pressing F5 or inside of the run menu, select start debugging. Let's create a new file, add some JavaScript that you want to test, save it. I will call it example.js, open command palette, run the extension, and here you go. Thank you for watching this video. If you want to pick the topics for the next videos, then join my Discord server, the link is in the description, and vote in the video ideas channel. Thank you, and see you in the next video.